evening, friends.
My name is Ravi Raj. I am the founder director of Netrack Enclosures Private Limited. We manufacture racks, containments, power distribution units to the data centers. The efficiency of the data center, managing the cold air, getting into the machine critical equipments. It can be servers or storage or the switches, getting into the machine critical equipments and coming out, the hot air coming out of the machine critical equipments, going back to the PAC is very important. How we do in the racks containment is a very important for the data center to get a good efficiency. We have just shown the extreme situation. Today most of the data centers or the server rooms are not like this. If it is very organized in a very bad way, if you do the thermal imaging, you can see there is hot air cold air mixing and thermal hotspots. Actually, see, whenever we meet the customer, the frequent questions customer ask, like, what is the necessity of deploying a containment, and how by deploying the containments, how much temperature we can increase, or what is the increase in the efficiency, and how this will help the airflow management. So with our experience, we have made 6 zones where we can manage the airflow. One is rise flow below the rack, then inside the rack, then further enhancing the airflow management with the brush modules. Then we have air diverter kit and side airflow for side airflow devices, because some of the Cisco switches has a airflow from front to right or left. So we have special equipments to manage that. Then managing the rear side of the rack, and then the around the rack. These are the 6 zones where we can manage the airflow. When it comes to the rise floor, in a normal practice, people will cut the tile and take the cables just like that, so that we can see the cold air is escaping from the cutout in the area where cables are not there, and this will definitely mix with the hot air and reduce the efficiency of the data center. So how this can be, this is a bad practice actually, and I think most of the data centers or the server rooms are come with the brush tiles, which is again our product, where we can take the we can replace the tile with the brush tile, and the cables can get into the racks through the brushes, so that it will reduce the cold air leakage, eliminate the pollution during cutting, eliminate cable damages due to bad tile cutting, and easiness of the relocation. Because if the design changes are there, you may have to change the tile from front to back or back to front. It can be done very easily. And these are all available in 3 models. One is single cut, single brush, 2 brush and 3 brush. Again, one important thing what we have seen in the data centers or the server rooms, customers are going with the wheel option, caster and leveler option, where we are seeing the cold air directly passes below the rack and mixes with the hot air which is in the backside. It will definitely reduce the efficiency of the data center actually. So recommended, the best practice is we have to use the plinth instead of caster and leveler. Then all unused areas should be covered with the blank panels, and also there is a gap between the frame and the 19-inch verticals in the rack that has to be covered with the air seal kit. Then we are talking about further airflow management through the brush modules. There are brush modules available for the top panels, bottom panels, and the air seal kit is again brushed, and the blank panel is again brushed when we are taking the cable from front to back. Generally, people will just take the cables from front to back. Again, the cold air mixes with the hot air. It will create hot spots. It will mix with the hot air, and the efficiency further reduces actually. This is a air diverter kit where to manage the airflow of the side airflow devices. See, generally in most of the servers or a storage, the airflow will be from front to back. So it is very easy to manage by just by putting a blank panels and a air seal kit and using a plinth, we can ensure the air flow into the mission critical equipment and come out of the rack on the back side, and it will go back to the PAC. But there are some equipments where the airflow enters the equipment from the front, but hot air comes out of the right side of the equipment actually. So when we have these equipments, this will create a thermal short circuit in the rack. To avoid this, we have a very innovative product, air diverter kit, which will ensure the air coming from the right side to get into the air diverter kit, and it will route the air to go back from the back door actually. There are two options here, one is active, one is passive. In the active, there are no fans. In the passive, there is no fans. In the active, there are fans. And also, we have another two options here. One is, for inside the rack, only for one equipment, we can give an air diverter kit and then air diverter frame. Frame can be, convert the complete rack to a side airflow to manage the side airflow equipments. Then we are at the last topic where managing the cable from the back side of the rack. Typically, whether somebody likes or don't like, most of the data centers or most of the server rooms, this is a situation where the cables are hanging around on the back-end side, which can be managed properly with the proper cable organizers, a short length power cards and the short length patch cards, so that the hot air will move out of the rack very comfortably and get into the PAC. Then we have to manage the air around the rack, we have cold air containment, then we have hot air containments. Customer can pick and choose whatever is convenient and whatever is suitable for their design. So that's it. If you have any questions, we can discuss. Okay, thank you.
Thanks, Raviraj.